Roll call 219, and I'm at the farm today shooting. Today we're gonna shoot the FNS 9mm. So I've already shot this gun before, and it ran. All the magazines worked, no malfunctions. I shot this last weekend, so we're gonna shoot it again. I have not cleaned this gun since that range session, just to see how it would hold up. I don't know if you can see it in the camera, probably not. Don't have a flashlight, but it's pretty dirty. Stick my finger in there. You can see it's pretty dirty in there. While I was going through my safe, I did find some ammunition I could shoot, which is the blue bullets from Foose, from Sport Shooter Ammunitions, that I bought while I was in Tulsa, Oklahoma. I'll position the camera. We're not gonna shoot for accuracy. We're gonna just continue to shoot to see how this gun functions. Maybe we'll mix in some accuracy down the road. Right now, we're just gonna shoot and try and make good groups. The last time I shot this gun, it was a little weird. I've never owned an FN. But I got this on a great deal for $300 through a private sale. The guy that owned this gun before me said he didn't shoot the gun well. He didn't like it. So, I mean, that's one of those things. Just because somebody says it's a good gun, don't forget, if you do buy these firearms, you're not going to get what you put into it. So $300 for this gun, it's pretty good. I've been seeing them around the $460, almost $500 mark. So $300 is a heck of a deal. So we're gonna run a couple magazines through here, and then we'll talk about the gun a little bit more. So here we go. The first couple of rounds of the blue stuff, and we'll see how it runs. So I think I got a few more magazines there. And I think I have another one somewhere. We'll find it. So we're gonna shoot this from, like, I don't know, a couple of feet. Nothing too dramatic. So here we go. All right, so it seems to work. So we'll get another magazine, and we'll give it another shot. Here we go. Oop. All right, so we have another magazine. What I've noticed is I'm shooting left. I'm pretty good at shooting left for some reason. So we're gonna try and straighten that out. Here we go. All right, we got that magazine done. Now that's better. So getting the trigger reset on that seems to be working out. There we go. All right. So there it is. All right. So we'll get another magazine. All right, so the last magazine of the day, we'll put it in there, and then we'll shoot and see how this goes. All right. right. I think I got. Yeah, I think that's it. I think I got a bolt left. So I threw a round directly into the chamber, fired it without the magazine, so it doesn't have a magazine disconnect, which is pretty cool. I like that. I like that aspect of it. The FN, what can I say about it? It's a good shooting gun. The first magazine I put through there, just like the first time I've shot this gun, it was left. I have a tendency to do that with guns I'm not familiar with. If I brought out my CZ or my Glock, I'd probably be spot on because I've shot those guns. This is the second time I've shot it. There is an ammo shortage, so I was lucky to find these rounds in the back of the safe. So maybe if you've been collecting all kinds of ammo over the past couple of years, dig back in that safe and you might find some extra rounds you could expend. But all in all, the gun functioned well, no malfunctions through all the ammo we shot today. Those were reloads that I bought when I was in Tulsa, Oklahoma. So I want to thank Foose for giving me a good deal on it. Bought about 500 rounds from them. And that's kind of the ammunition I shoot, just you know, target practice and whatnot. But the FNS 9mm, go and find one. Give it a try. It's not for everyone. It's starting to work for me. The more and more I shoot it, the more and more I practice the trigger reset on it. I like the gun. It's working well. No malfunctions, no magazine problems or anything of that nature. So that's really key. FN makes a great gun. The 503 just came out, which is their compact version. It is a single stack gun, but it looks promising. If you want to carry something that's a little bit smaller, anything like that, or you can't see it, but I got my 365 on my hip. So if you don't want to carry anything in that Glock 19 range, that might be a gun to look at. You can get to a range that lets you rent guns and shoot them, and they have the 503 in there. Give it a shot, see if you like it, other than the full size versions or those mid compact versions. So for me, I like the FN. It shoots well. I just got to get used to this stuff with all the configuration of it. But my hand sits well in it. I can reach the controls without breaking my grip and having to manipulate the firearm. Quick one. It is ambidextrous. So left-hand shooters, you have the magazine release on both sides and the slide lock on both sides of the firearm. So this is a good gun to get one of your left-handed shooter friends into, because it offers that feature. Most Glocks don't, some SIGs do, and then some CZs are also designed for left-handed shooters. So far it's a good gun. Hopefully the shortage of ammunition will kind of slow down here now that we're reaching the curve for the buggy bug. So maybe 9mm will be readily available. It's still not available at my shop. So hopefully that trend will start to curve along with the curve of the bug. And then you can get back to shooting, get back to experiencing more and more firearms like we have in the past. With all that being said, I want to thank you, my old and my new subscribers, just the people that zip through my channel. I greatly appreciate it. Like, comment, subscribe, share my content. We're creeping up to the 600 subscriber mark. It's going to be a really good giveaway. If you're interested in Patreon, there'll be a link down below. I've asked my Patreons if they can't afford to do Patreon at this moment due to being out of work, because a lot of people are out of work at this point. Don't put your money towards this effort. Save it for you and your family. That's more important than giving to the channel. The channel's always going to survive unless YouTube starts freaking out like they usually do. But save that money. If you do want to donate to the channel, the link will be down there in the description of the video. That way, you can help the channel out that way. But always like, comment, share, and subscribe your favorite gun content, whether it be mine's or one of the other channels you watch. Again, I want to thank you. And like always, guys, we'll catch you on the next one.